the Green Bay Packers taking on Kyler Murray and the Arizona Cardinals.
Historic Lambeau Field. Fittingly, it butts up against Lombardi Avenue here in the heart of Green Bay, Wisconsin. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with the Arizona Cardinals. Get this one started, and off we go from Lambeau. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25. Here we go with the Packer offense, guided by their decorated QB with a long list of Pro Bowls and other accolades next to his name, of course. Aaron Rodgers leading the way.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four, second and six.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Rodgers now on first down. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. And gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. And really gets them amped up as they go forward.
This is Cobb with a catch right side. Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. 5 yards, and that means they come up short as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive. Fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. And just a net of 31 here, 40-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. He'll be led out by their Pro Bowl quarterback. third season now out of Oklahoma, the former number one overall pick, of course, Kyler Murray.
And when you have a guy like Kyler Murray under center, it not only opens up your playbook, it allows you to draw up even more plays because he's among the best dual threat quarterbacks in the league and a true playmaker. If flushed out of the pocket, he might even be more dangerous. The next step for him, being able to throw on rhythm and deliver from the pocket.
Murray now on first down. And complete to Zach Ertz. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the broken tackle. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
First carry for James Conner. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Defensively, six DBs, so a dime look on third.
Could play coverage or bring pressure.
To throw, it's Murray. And he finds his tight end, it's Ertz. And he will get this to the midfield stripe, but that's not going to be enough. He's a few yards short. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
That pattern and scheme was well defensed on third down. He tried to just sprint from one side of the field to the other, and they got it to him quickly. But no chance at yards after the catch there, and they stop him short.
On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at the 20. Now he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, Kai just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
Now it's second and 9. Rodgers now to throw. Caught right side. It's Lewis. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. A big play there, Rodgers to Cobb, 47 yards.
Well, dialing up that play call certainly meant that he grabbed a little extra shot of courage on that one, because normally on third and short, you're just trying to move the sticks, get the ball just past that line of scrimmage. Instead, they take the big shot downfield, and it pays off.
Now on first down, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure, when you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
Yeah, that was the safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind. He hits like a linebacker, and we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Throwing now is Rodgers. And that is incomplete. Now they're staring at a fourth down as Arizona's defense does its job.
Tight defense there on third down, but what a product of good coaching and even better execution, because he realized he's in field goal range, no sense forcing anything, and he made sure he didn't.
So now on fourth down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. The kick by Crosby is good, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning of that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to the goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. Set to return it, here's Moore. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks, because then the defense has the advantage.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Murray, that's out to the flat for Edmonds.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Working with a second and 4. They'll go option to the short side. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. He'll get get two on the keeper, but it becomes now a third down.
Typically on the read option play, when we talk about responsibilities, we're talking about what the quarterback has to go through. How about the inside linebacker, though? His job on this play, shadow the quarterback and hold him to a short gain. Did it to perfection.
They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. Murray fighting, lost the football, and the Packers pick it up. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
We've got plenty of weather here today. We've got some snow going on, and they've come out of a dome. And there have been two ways of getting ready for this. Some have said, don't worry about the weather. Just practice in your normal conditions and handle it on game day. And others have said, find some weather, find some conditions somewhere, and try and get ready. What do you think?
Well, whatever the preparation there, the snow causing the fumble. So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Fake the give. Now Rodgers. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The first red zone opportunity now for the Packers. It's first and 10 at the 14. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Second and six from the 10. The give is to Jones. Get the guard there, Lucas Patrick.
Still second down.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now it's Rodgers. He goes right back to Adams. That's complete. Touchdown! It's Devontae Adams hauling it in from Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers add on to their lead.
When you're a great route runner, it makes you that much better as a receiver because now your quarterback trusts that you're going to be where he expects and he's able to deliver the ball on time.
Mason Crosby for the point after. Boy, these may be an adventure this afternoon, but this one is good. So that drive, four plays, and the result, a Green Bay score. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. Moore now to return. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at the 31-yard line. He'll start the drive with a give to Connor. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
On second and 9, Murray. And this is Ertz with it, right side. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
So now third and 7, and defensively, it's a dime look, 6 DBs. Here's Murray. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Now the first carry for Chase Edmonds, and they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Nice run defense presented there, and what I mean by that is discipline. Guys filling the right gaps in the right holes, no one over pursuing, and making a very nice play.
Second and 9. Out of the gun, here's Murray. Ertz over the middle. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. Nothing to score after one on EA Sports. The Cardinals on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Shotgun now for Murray. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now 4th down.
They had enough yards for the first down, but a clutch hit right there defensively. Jars it free. No 1st down.
Andy Lee now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked out and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Aaron Rodgers, he's getting ready to go again here on offense. They've got the lead. He's a big reason why. Looking sharp so far.
And as we travel around the league, we see quarterbacks get it done in a variety of ways. But today's NFL does tell us one thing. If that guy doesn't play well, their team's not going to win. And right now, he's got his team in the lead.
And now they'll look to extend that lead. 1st and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. The drive starts with a carry by Dillon, and he'll fight forward on the straight-ahead running for just a couple of yards, 2nd down.
Well, not a game that you're going to go crazy about, but when you start at your own 2-yard line, any type of space is good for the offensive guys.
Yeah, you just can't go backwards from here. They did it. Now we'll see if they can keep it on schedule here on second down. Back near the goal line, here's Rodgers. And they'll get him down up past the 15.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So a little breathing room now. First and 10 at the 17. Here's Rodgers to throw. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. Jordan Phillips, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6. Well, I think that time he just maybe held on to it a little too long, CD, because after a couple of seconds in this league, you know those defenders are coming.
And how many times do we talk about complementary football? We're usually talking about, does the offense help the defense? Does the defense help the offense? I think in this case, does the quarterback help out his offensive line? You only have a certain amount of time to get rid of the football. They can only do so much. On this play, he took them to the limits.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Rodgers gonna throw. And able to find Alan Lazard. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. I love that play, because in the snow you think run, run, run. Big passing play there.
And defenders hate it, especially in open space, because trying to come under control, break down, and make a tackle in the open field, difficult in normal conditions. In these conditions, almost impossible.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll try the right side with Jones. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold him to a 2-yard run, but I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run, one that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
Throwing on second and 8. Rodgers throwing the out route incomplete. It's Lewis. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer. Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Running right, Jones. He takes this for about 6 down inside the 40.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Four yards remain for second down. And now it's Valdez Scantling on the end around. And he's taken down inside the 30. An excellent run there coming from out wide.
And we used to consider these jet sweeps to be gadget plays or something a little bit unusual, right? But now most teams have some version of this play in their playbook. And I think it's a lot because of the receivers that are being developed nowadays. These guys look like running backs, even though they're playing out on the perimeter.
first and 10. Here's Rodgers. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Adams. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. And he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Here's Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. And he's going to have a Packers first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. They're going to run the jet sweep. It's Cobb with it. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Randall Cobb. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Packers go 98 yards and finish it off in the end zone. Well, we've talked about it before. You know, this jet sweep, something a lot of teams like to run nowadays, and this one winds up in the end zone.
And it is all about creating different ways to get the ball in the hands of your playmakers. And wasn't it interesting that prior to this game, head coach told us, I saw this sitting in my chair watching a Tuesday night college game and decided to implement it myself.
You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And that makes our score 17-0. After the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And Moore, he's going to sit on this one, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. All right, here now a look at A.J. Green. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? Second quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us, but sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. Murray and the Cardinals with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start with a give to Connor, and he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Edmonds running out of the shotgun, and he powers his way up past the 30. 4 yards on the pickup there, as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st. This effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
It Packers looking at a dime formation. Six defensive backs on the field. So he's looking for anyone to throw the football to. But he didn't have anyone open, so he took off and ran for it. But he came up just short, and that brings up fourth down.
Here's Andy Lee now, as he's on to punt for Arizona. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And here's Rodgers on the return. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Rodgers setting up the screen here. Aaron Jones. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to it and hold it for just a short gain.
The Packers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 8. Now Rodgers. Open man, this is Lewis. He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
But things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 34. To throw is Rodgers. And Jones has it over the middle. It'll be a gain of 5, and it'll make it second down.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, and maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
The Packers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Throwing is Rodgers. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. They'll wind up losing a couple yards here on the play, and it'll be 4th down. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And Crosby puts it through, And the lead now increases to 20-0. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. And no run back here for Moore. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25. There's A.J. Green as he gets set to go again on offense. They've got to find a way to get him more involved in this game plan. Down here in the second quarter, he doesn't even have a catch.
And don't think they're not hearing about it in the huddle and on the sidelines. And we often think of wide receivers at times being disruptive. It's just that they know their talents, and they know the type of plays they can make, and they can make big ones. They want the ball to help their team.
Yeah, you got to think he's going to want the ball more. One target, no catches. On first and 10, here's Murray. He'll get this to his running back, Edmonds. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try to put some points on the board.
Here's a ball thrown right side and complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. In this weather, any big play in the passing game, that's just a bonus, right?
It certainly is, but oftentimes offenses think inclement weather plays to their advantage because you know where you're going on offense. Defenders have to react, and they often slip.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Murray, caught by the tight end Ertz. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Murray to air it out again. Finding Ertz again. And down inside the 15 he goes. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. The Cardinals into the red zone for the first time. They have a first and 10 at the 13-yard line. Murray now to throw. This is caught, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Murray gonna throw. Open man, Green, he's got it. Touchdown, Arizona. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Cardinals are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed, and a lot of football, full half to be played. Extra point good by Prater, and that cuts this lead down to 13. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Rodgers on the return. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. Out comes Devontae Adams in the offense for their next drive. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate them.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. On first down, Rodgers toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Here's second and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Shot before half for Rodgers, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. The snow certainly making conditions difficult, and it's not likely to get better anytime soon, as we turn it right back over to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Too many breaks ahead, according to the radar. More snow on the horizon as we are back underway in half number two. More now on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 right at the 30. Sliding out of the pocket. Murray with a nice move. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
First down, Murray. They'll roll him out right. And Murray with a smart move there at the end of the play. Picks up the first down and then slides to the ground.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's Murray. And his throw here's incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Murray flips his forward on a jet sweep. And he's going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Murray now. Quick slant, caught by Moore. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Throwing on first down is Murray. Again, he finds Moore. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
And these two hooked up on a nice gain to play before, and I always admire play callers that see a play that works and go right back to it, so they went right back to him. The reward, they're set up with first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. To throw is Murray. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football, and the Packers pick it up. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Playing in snow brings so many other factors into the game. It's not just trying to take care of the ball, and we just saw there that that's difficult to do, but just trying to keep your feet and carry out your assignments and make sure you're comfortable while you're out there playing. Are you warm enough in your clothing? A million things going on, but the biggest one, hold on to the ball.
After the fumble recovery, it's Rodgers. A gain of 6 there on first. For that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Second down at 4. To throw, it's Rodgers. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Adams. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Rodgers now to throw. And that's complete to Adams. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
That's another beautiful throw right there. Gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been on it. And they pick up another first down there.
Midfield, here's Rodgers. This one swung out here to Jones. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that'll make it a second down. Rodgers going to give this one to Dillon. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
Sometimes being a linebacker in the middle of the field is kind of like being a doctor on the field. You got to make the right diagnosis. Here he correctly sends his run and shoots through to make the play in the backfield.
Chance. This is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now, looking at a 3rd and 3. Now it's Rodgers. And a throw there going to be incomplete. But the other day they told us, when we've got 3rd and 5 or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
On now is the Packers punter, as he's on here to punt it away. And now the up man has it. It's a fake. So they get the first down. Maybe not a huge play in terms of yardage, but the fake punt does the job. So they snap it straight to the up man. What's his responsibility? Normally, obviously, just to protect, but he's got to be a guy that can be pretty agile too, right?
Yeah, without a doubt, because you're talking about a guy, even in protection, he may have to slide up and down the line of scrimmage to pick up someone who comes through trying to block a punt. So you know he's got that ability to move, but oftentimes it's usually a running back, a fullback, someone who's used to having the ball in their hands, and he's able to pick up the first down.
A first down run here by Jones as he'll take it forward for a gain of about four.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Throwing now is Rodgers. And his throw is incomplete. The veteran tight end, Mercedes Lewis, the intended receiver. But now it's third down. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last four or five plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, and we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play.
When the offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
Now on first down to Valdez Scantling over the middle and inside the 20 before he's brought down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. And he's brought down.
Well, this is a well-orchestrated drive they've put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out, but they've gone on a march since then. And now after that completion there, they've got a first and goal.
Dillon will score. Touchdown, Packers. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
So now Rodgers will lead the Packers up to go for two. Rodgers will throw for it. Flushed out right. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst, and if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
After after the touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. Set to return it. Here's Moore. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. Rondale Moore. And finally, he's out of bounds. But how about that return? All the way inside the 20 and into the red zone. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Out of the gun, here's Murray. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
Yeah, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah.
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Rashawn Gary coming in hard that time on the blitz, and he gets him down. It's a loss of 4.
When you're this close to the goal line, you got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now. 3rd and 10. Throwing now is Murray. Forced out to his left. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Kyler Murray taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Cardinals cut into that lead. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns 3rd and goal into a touchdown. Now Prater to add the PAT. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. Just a 4-play drive that time. And the play that polished it off was the touchdown run by Kyler Murray. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Marching back onto the field now, Devontae Adams and company getting set to go. And he is just one reception away from 10 in this game. I don't know what they need to do defensively, but something has to be altered, does it not?
I know that whenever we tried to cover a person who was having a game like this,
You're trying to vary what you're doing, trying to change things up, hoping to fool him occasionally. If not fool him, fool the quarterback so that maybe he doesn't read the coverage correctly. Right now, though, they're in pretty good sync.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. 41 yards rushing for them now to this point.
Well, I think after that run, the defense get back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Here's Jones again on second down, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run, and at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. On the handoff, this is Dillon. He'll get about 4 as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end-of-the-half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bed.
The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack. Isaiah Simmons just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Well, when you time those screen passes perfectly, they can work perfectly, but that time it took a little too long to develop.
And you zeroed in on exactly what makes that play go. Timing. Because if the timing's off at all, those unblocked defenders coming at the quarterback, they'll put him on the deck.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we've played 3 quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Packers on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Rodgers going to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
So into Cardinal territory now. It's 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Caught by Cobb. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is 2nd and less than a yard. They go back to the ground with Jones. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he stopped immediately there. Jordan Phillips is the one on the stop. run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
The Packers on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third down and 12. Here's Rodgers to throw. Caught on the right side by Jones. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. A give to Jones. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Partner, one thing I was lousy at growing up, track and field, I could never anticipate the start before a race. But how about that backer? He figured it out, jumped the count, and turned it into a really nice play for his defense.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Here's Rodgers. And that one's going to be off target and incomplete. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
This offense, 2 for 2 on third downs on this drive. They're in for a tough test here, though. Third and long. Operating from the gun, Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So now on fourth down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. The kick by Crosby is good. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So an important one there as they widen their lead in this fourth quarter.
All right, partner, help me out with the math here. Make sure I am on point because the way I see it, the other guys still need 2 touchdowns, but in addition, a 2-point conversion. So this is all about them playing perfect football from here on out.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. On the return, Rondale Moore will bring it out. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Murray and the Cardinals. Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 27. Throwing to start the drive, Murray. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. To throw, it's Murray. Rolling to, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Chris Barnes gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A.
Now, you've been around me a long time now. You know on second and inches, I love it when teams are aggressive and take a shot, but we just saw the downside to being that aggressive, didn't we?
Now you've given up on a pretty likely first down if they had run the football, and they need to come up with something here on third. The Cardinals on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 5. Here's Murray. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackle. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Green Bay's offense ready to go again. Now, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers, this one to the right, caught by Valdez-Scantling. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Rodgers going to try and throw on 3rd down. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Cobb. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
Well, you can absolutely feel the thought process there. They just gave up the touchdown. So in the huddle, they're telling each other, you don't want to give it back now on a 3 and out. Nice job of making sure that they wouldn't, and they pick up the 1st down.
Throwing on 1st down is Rodgers. And he hits his target, the tight end Lewis. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
2nd and 6. No, scratch that. 2nd and 7. From the gun, it's Rodgers. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 38-yard line.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. Rodgers to throw once more. Complete. This is Lewis. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? At this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. 57 yards on the ground for him so far. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys, they're just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
Second down, another shot for Jones. He will push his way down to about the 14. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
They're a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's 3rd and a yard. And they'll go jet sweep to try to pick it up. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's in a full run by the time he gets the football.
Chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Aaron Jones, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Packers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
Touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Arizona's offense back out and ready to go.
They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Murray now on first down. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Defensively, you look at the numbers. Another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of five straight games without a 200-yard game. And that was a big talk, both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them, holding them under 200 today.
Now he'll escape to his left, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. Shotgun now for Murray. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. And it was the stiff arm there that freed him enough to get the first before he's tackled. So he needed one. He ended up getting three.
And I really like the way he ran that one, too. That's really intelligent running because oftentimes a running back could get too greedy. Try and hit the home run on a play where you just need a few yards. Well done there, making sure he got the first down and not worrying about trying to get a touchdown.
Murray getting this complete to Connor. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. On first and 10, here's Murray. He'll get this to Connor underneath. So nothing doing there, and it'll be second and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Second and 10. Now Murray. Buying time to his left. And he's got this down to the 35.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Murray going to throw. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively,
stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. And now we get to deal with a foot of snow in the parking lot as we say so long from Green Bay.
Love it here. This is Maui with snow.
That's one way to put it. So long.